everyone, this is my tagged video. I know it's taken a while, but my camera was broken, but I'm back now. I hope I can fill you in on some stuff that you might want to know. First. Trying to write a song for a while. It's called Long Road, and I thought I'd share it with you because it's really hard to find things to put in the tagged video. So I thought, why not put some original songs I've been working on. So this one's it's a slowish sort of song, but I always get stuck on the chorus. That's the thing with me. Choruses, yeah. Oh, actually, some songs, no, it's not too bad. But usually choruses really are hard for me. So. Lay my hand across the sky. And again. Lay my hand across the sky. Watch to see the colors fade and bleed into the winter. The sun had gone but lingered on, so beavers stay behind. And a blizzard froze four walls around this little heart of mine. Oh no. Drop your head towards the ground and wave your smile to hide your frown, and you walk around like everything's alright. You shrugged it off, it's no big deal. The pain inside, the things you fear, the stuff we bury deep that no one ever sees. And this is where I'm stuck.
Say, I only hear what I want to.
There you go. I can see. No, I just never wear them, but I do. I wear glasses.
Sunset.
You might have seen in a couple of my videos, I don't know, that I'm wearing a cross. I am a Catholic. I was baptised in 2002. I've been sent heaps of messages on YouTube about, just different opinions, ideas, and about spirituality. And my thought is everyone should make up their own mind. I think it's a personal thing, your relationship with God. I'm a Catholic, but I don't go to church every Sunday. I probably should, but my aunt's a nun, and I've learned a lot from her. But I think in the end, it's just up to everyone. It's their own personal journey, I guess. I just want to share a page out of this book that I found inspiring. It's called Love Without Conditions by Paul Farini. There it is, if you can see it. I'll just read this page because it's interesting. He's got some interesting ideas in here. Okay.
Let me begin by saying that I speak through you only to the extent that you are willing to relinquish control. In that sense, you are not special. I can speak through anyone who has the willingness. What you hear has a great deal to do with what is already present in your mind. Each person who opens to my voice will hear it according to his own perceptions and preconceptions. That is inevitable. The desire to communicate with me is essential to opening the door to my presence. I will not force myself upon anyone. The relationship with me is voluntary and must be initiated by each person when he is ready. I am as close to you as you would have me be. That is because I am already a thought within your mind, and everything that I am proceeds from that thought, just as everything which is not me proceeds from a different thought. This you must learn through experience. Some claim that I speak through them, yet they are listening to a different voice. My voice never condemns or makes fearful. My intention is to bless everyone. I would have each of you know, once and for all, that you are not guilty except in your own mind, and that imagined guilt can and must be undone. My teaching is a simple one. I teach forgiveness of sins. I teach that sin itself is not real. It seems to be real only because you believe that you can be injured. You believe that you are the body. And so when the body has been injured, you believe that an injustice has been done to you. And then it goes on. But it's a really good book. And anyone who's sort of wanting a different view about things. Yeah, it's a good book to open your mind to that. Yeah.
My blue-eyed son, oh, where have you been, my darling young one? I've stumbled on side of 12 misty mountains. I've walked and I've...
We're happy little veggie magnets, bright as bright can be.
We all enjoy our veggie mites for breakfast, lunch and tea. Our mummy said we're growing stronger every single week. Because we love our veggie mites. We all adore our veggie mites.
That is about all you have on your bread. Not much. And then... Mmm. Well,